Alright, here comes the first bounce. To be thrown up by the umpire. Tapped away, it's gone through. Looks like that's Riveros running away with the ball for Chile. He's streaking down the field. 2-1-1 in the forward line, and the mark has been taken by Contreras about 10-15 metres out from goal, pretty much directly in front. And this would be the ideal start to the game for Chile if they could get this one through here. He steps up and he has slotted it straight through the middle. That is a great way to start for Chile, putting them one ahead in this grand final. Lionel straight back in the middle. South Africa already with a bit of early work to do, but there is a lot of time to go in this game. The ball is tossed up again. Coming forward is Fredericks. It's been pinched away, and again, it looks like it's Riveros running again in a similar route. And the mark has been taken. Immediately looks inboard. And he plays on and goes straight through the middle. Oh, no, he has missed, actually, just to the side. From this angle, it looks like he'd gone through, but he has just missed to the left-hand side of the post. That is Enmer Baragesi. The ball is kicked out, and it is taken by the captain, Dupree, in the middle, and he's going to kick it long down the field to 1-1. Vargas looked like he had a good jump at it. It's going again. That looks to be in the back from South Africa. It is, and it's going to be a free kick to Chile. Chile going to start on their own 22-metre line. They've got a long way to head back up the field. And it looks like it is going to be number 7, Vargas, who is going to start with the ball. That is Perry Vargas. There are 3 Vargas out on the field today. It's a good lead-up play there by number 11. And he's going to play on and turn straight away. Runs straight down the middle of the field. The mark there is taken by number 12. That is Richard Vargas, and he is going to take his time, take a couple steps back, and look towards the goals. This would be a long kick if he could make it. It's probably 30 metres out on a slight angle. It comes in with the left foot, and it is just off to the left. So a couple of close efforts for Chile nice and early. Kick out again is going to be taken by South Africa. And it is marked wide by, looks like Andrews out there on the wing. Kick down the line and it is intercepted by Soto down in the back pocket. He kicks it forward to Richard Vargas, who's going to take off again. Nice quick play early from Chile. He's going to kick it wide. And that is going to be sent back to the fullback, who's going to reset. And they're going to start again. That looks like, not sure who that is down there, but the captain for South Africa tries to get a hand on it, knocks it forward to Gary Andrews. He's going to send it wide again, and that is a good tackle that has been stuck, and it is given as holding the ball. Great tackle there from Richard Vargas for Chile. He's going to take the ball around about his own 10 metre mark, and he's going to look for some options going forward. Sees a lead, sends it over the head of Watts, who is leading for him. Looks like there might have been a potential high tackle going in there, but it's going to come back to South Africa, and they're going to try and reload from their own 22 this time. Long way to go. Looks like Andrew's out there on the wing. He's going to look long and wide to a big one-on-one. There was a bit of a push in the back there from the South African player. Might have been the captain, Dupree, again. So it's going to be sent back. There was a hand in there by de Kock, but it has unfortunately come free. Good numbers around the ball. And a nice tackle laid. Umpire's going to come and he's going to throw that one up. Well, that's going to be Vargas to go up that ball. Advantage called for Chile. Oh, it goes over the head of the full forward. It looks like there's a good tackle being laid back there. The snap around the body by a Chilean player, and that has gone through for a goal. might have been, I reckon, Brian Mary who scored that one. Not too sure. Either way, it is a two-goal lead for Chile now. Give me some early work South Africa to do. Still plenty of time left in this final. All players are back in position. And the umpire is going to throw the ball up. The tap has favoured South Africa there, but it's come back on the Chile side. Vargas has broken free and he has thrown the ball out wide to that number 11 again. The ball is dropped. And the Chile number 23, Mary, has sprayed it just wide. So South Africa getting away with a couple of lucky misses here. Chile providing the chance to South Africa to get themselves into this game and get set up to make a real charge for it. It is sent long down the line there. One arm attempt, and that looks like Lawrence who's going to send it long. And that is going to be the first goal for South Africa, scored by, I think that's actually the vice-captain, Taft, who scored that one. And that is a great goal to get them back and get them on the scoreboard for the first time in this final. So that is Chile 2, South Africa 1. Still plenty of time to go. So far, it's been a very competitive, very physical game. These two sides, a bit of a history in their first group match. Equally physical contest coming out right here. So again, we go, the ball's thrown up in the middle. Hasn't gone very far outside of the contest. Looks like it's going to be locked up and we will go again. Start again, the ball's gone up. Ball's been sent wide. He's trying to dance through a few bits of traffic and it has been given the umpire's call for the ball. Might have been a little bit lucky there. Oh, that looks like there was a good tackle and that might have been given either a throw or holding the ball. Either way, it is a Chilean free kick. And immediately, Maravilla is going to take off. He's going to pass it wide. It is then sent down the line and marked for running straight into a South African player. But he's going to get up and he might be thinking about a shot here. About 30 metres out, slight angle just to the right. This could make it restore that two-goal difference that they had a little bit earlier. He steps up, nice approach, and it is just off to the right. Lots of chances so far. Chile are probably looking for a bit of a better conversion so far, but that is a good intercept mark, just on the other side of the 10-meter line by Enmer Baragesi. And he sends it forward to number 17, Contreras, who is going to take it, and he looks like he's going to have a shot pretty much directly in front, same kind of range, 30 metres out. But so far, it doesn't look like anyone has had too much of an issue with that difference. So he's going to step in, a bit of a stutter step in the run-up. He's going to kick it long. Looks like it's missed to the left again. Probably the fourth or fifth time that one has gone to either side of the post, so lots of early chances. Could be much further ahead, Chile, right now, even though they do hold the lead. South African player recalled to start again from the goal line. He's looking wide out towards number two. That's Ensor out there. Takes a nice grab on the wing. Ensor surveying his options, seeing what he can spot down the wing. Goes straight down the wing. Bit of a push out there, and it has been paid by the umpire. Lawrence has given away that free. And it might have been lucky not to give away the extra 10-meter penalty there. But the free kick has gone to Sid. Has been sent forward to Vargas, who has got himself in a bit of traffic there, nearly got out of it. Nearly a high shot and has been paid by the umpire. It's a very physical contest, very congested. After the initial couple of bursts, not much free space. Sent out backwards and wide to the wing and it has opened up a free man in the middle there. Looks like it might be Maravilla and he can pass it off back to Riveros. That was a good tackle laid, but the ball has been sprayed free. There's a 2-on-1 out there, and it has been marked by, that looks like Perry Vargas out there on the wing. and he's going to have a look at the post from there. On a tough angle, only about 22 metres out, right on the line. A couple of steps back, maybe more like 20 metres. He comes in, he has a shot, and he has sprayed it left as well. Only about a third of the game gone, so there's still plenty of time. Neither team should be panicking at this point. Looking pretty calm. Good long ball straight down the middle. And that has been picked off by Jackson Vargas this time, the third of the Vargases. He's going to spread it wide. Fredericks was chasing but couldn't quite rein in his Chilean opponent. Goes through a big pack of players there. It's been taken by number 12, Richard Vargas, and he has put it straight through the post for Chile's third. And that is another goal. That makes it 3-1. Chile 3, South Africa 1. And that early field position, the early dominance, is now starting to show a little bit on the scoreboard for Chile. I'm just going to re-welcome my colleague here.
Thanks, BT.
Do you want to go back to the commentary position?
Yeah. What an incredible game that we've just had.
We have just seen a great game, and this game is living up to that expectation. The women's and the men's games.
It's been an absolute banger day. So here we are again. And Chile emerged with it after a massive tap out from the South African ruckman. The South African player there.
I think there might have been a bit of a game for British Bulldogs.
Goes for a bit of body contact well before his opposing player kicks the ball.
Riveros has sprayed it down the line. And
Riveros. Vargas, I think it was. Who?
Vargas has taken the mark, I think, in the forward line. And this should be a much easier shot for Chile to make. Not very far out, not much of an angle, and he has put it straight through the middle for Chile's fourth. Really starting to see that dominant show on the scoreboard now.
I think you might have gone missing there, BT.
I've gone missing.
Yeah, you're back now.
Oh, we're back now.
Good to see. So the umpire throws the ball high in the air, and the tussle continues as number 3 Vargas gets involved again. Jackson Vargas, that is. Fair tussle, but number 12 Richard Vargas, his brother, was pushed in the back. It's a free kick to Chile.
About 10 metres out.
Viva Chile, as they like to say.
10 metres on the other side. Vargas is going to spray it. Oh, there's a man free. And he has taken the mark.
Great vision.
Number 18, the captain, Fernando Cabrera, has taken the mark out in the forward pocket.
Yeah, great vision with the kick to Cabrera there.
Is it a forward pocket on the rugby field?
No.
It's the forward right flank, you could say.
Thank you very much. Around the area of
it's in the forward.
I don't know, a line out or something. I don't know rugby that well. So
he comes in and it looks like it's gone to the left again.
Is not good.
Been a bit of a story of the first half, but they have started to convert a lot of their chances now. A 3-goal lead to Chile at this point. South Africa just haven't had it down their end of the field. Oh, and that is a great mark from Cameron Ensor.
Oh, here he is.
He tells his team to go long.
Here he is, the man, Cameron Ensor.
Oh,
inside the
over.
22. Can they score from here? A clever kickoff, accidental kick off the ground from Chile.
And it looks like they've rushed it through.
Rends the ball dead, and it's going to be rushed.
That was a very nice play there from Chile. They saw the danger, and they just won that foot race to get back.
Last minute here in the first half at Box Hill Rugby Club.
That's Vargas again.
Number 12, Vargas comes in with the goods. Sends it down deep for Chile. And this bloke with the inside-out bender.
The banana.
It's no good, unfortunately. The inside-out bender. And BT, you're supposed to be good with those one-liners, mate. Your initials are BT. What's going on, mate?
I'm clearly in the team. And oh, there's a big intercept from number 3 of Chile, and he's got the banana.
Vargas
on
goal.
That one is a goal. What an exceptional shot that is. That is a super shot.
Super shot indeed.
That is a super shot.
Don't you love those Pete Laserisms?
Mate, the score is 5-1. And I believe that is going to be half time.
Yep.
So, as we go into the halftime break, I believe the score is Chile 5, South Africa 1, in the Men's Division 2 final.
Yeah.
Ball gets thrown up, we're back on. So now we've got South Africa are going to be attacking the building's end or the house end, and Chile are going to be attacking the road end, and Vargas breaks away very quickly, and it is touched on the line by a South African player, and they're going to rush it through. I believe a corner kick has been called for a deliberate rush behind or a deliberate out of bounds. So it's going to be a Chile ball from the corner post. And it looks like Groble has grabbed it and he's going to clear it out of the area. There's a good contest there and it looks like South African player is going to wrap up the Chilean player there. I'm not sure who that is. That was like Contreras over there. Zumba's going to throw the ball up again. Number 7 nearly gets through. Drops the ball, that's Perry Vargas, but it looks like it is going to be a Chile free kick for below the knees, I believe. So, number 7, Perry Vargas steps up, 22 metres out. On a slight angle. He's going to kick. And he's just missed to the left.
To the right. To the front. And to behind. Love those memes. So South Africa inbound again.
Great mark by Lawrence down the line. And
numbers impossible to identify, I must say, though, BT. How can you do this?
Oh, it's great. It's good eyesight is what it is. It's very hard on there. Jumper, that's right.
I clearly don't have that. Boy, oh boy.
Unfortunately, the ball has been taken out over the goal line, so it looks like it will be a kick into Chile again. Of course, South Africa trying to chase down that half-time deficit. They were down 5-1, so still 4 goals to make up in the second half. Very similar situation to what we saw in the women's final as well. Now the ball's been kicked out wide, out towards the sideline. South Africa looking like they've got most of the X lane covered, but Vargas has snuck outside, Richard Vargas that is, and he has taken the mark out on the wing. He has gone long down the line towards Perry Vargas that is, but it looks like it might be cut off down there by, maybe that looks like it might be Butler down there. Well, I think Lawrence might have shepherded it out over the goal line for a kick-in. It does look like the umpire has called a second corner kick. I haven't seen many of these at all today, but there's been two in the second half already, both to Chile. Oh, some good fancy footwork there, and he's snuck inside. He's taken a bounce. He snapped for the goals. Oh, and he's just missed. It's a good piece of solo work there. Would have made for one of the better goals we've seen today. But instead, South Africa's going to try and rebound. Lets it go through. Now Cam Ansori's going to pull some fancy footwork. Comes through. Looks like that was Andrews there. Couldn't quite get it to Ansori. Might have been his intended target. But there's a good tackle applied. Ansori again. Pushes it down the line, but... Oh, and it is marked just inside. Looks like it was floating out of bounds. Lawrence kicks it across towards what looks like the vice-captain Taft, and he has had a shot, and he has scored. That is 1 goal back on the board for South Africa. The score is 5-Chile, 2-South Africa. Still plenty of time to go in this half, only 3 goals down now. South Africa are going to. They're going to keep attacking. They're going to keep trying to get those goals. Now it's back in the middle. Looks like it might be Dupree, the captain, in there against Vargas in the ruck. out to Lawrence. He's going to send it forward. There's very positive attacking football. Punch back inside. Number two for South Africa, Enzo, is going to get it. He's going to kick it down the line. Number 24 is going to have a shot. And he's, it's taken a nasty bounce and it's gone to the other side of the post for no score. Very lucky for Chile there. Unlucky for South Africa. It's not going their way at the moment. And that is a nice clearing kick, getting rid of all that pressure. Out to Richard Vargas. Number 12, he's going to send it nice and long. Good mark taken by the South African defender there. He's got to hurry, he's got someone right behind him. He hands it off to Lawrence, who has even less time. There's a bit of pressure going on here. Some rushed decisions. Not much composure. A whistle is gone. And it looks like it might be a free kick to number 12, Richard Vargas. He's going to get the ball again. It's been a very tight contest in the second half. Very end-to-end stuff. Lots of good counter-attacking football. So Richard Vargas is going to spray it across to Perry Vargas, number 7. But it's going to go past him and all the way through to the boundary. That's going to be retrieved by some of the amazing fans we have in the crowd today. Scores do indeed remain the same. It is still Chile 5, South Africa 2. And Cam Ensor in the forward line has out-muscled his opponent and has taken it on the 22-metre line directly in front. This is a great opportunity for South Africa to get another one back. Still plenty of time remaining. They need to take all their chances. He steps in, nice measured approach. And he has slotted the goal. What a great pressure goal there by Ensor. He is getting his team back in the game. The score now is Chile 5, South Africa 3. Great work so far from South Africa in the second half. Still plenty of time, still about half the... South Africa scored that goal, so the score, South Africa has 3, Chile has 5. The ball is tapped out by Chile, but on the South African side of halfway. Good dive in there from, look like, the captain. He has tapped the ball out. Play on, says the umpire, might have been a throw, but he has said play on. Number 12 looks like Vargas, he is going to spray it in the middle. Not his best kick, but it has landed favourably for Perry Vargas. He's handballed it out wide. And he has just missed. Some nice backing music for that little campaign forward. South Africa are going to take the measured approach out of defence. Two South Africans, Cam Ensor is at the front. He has got it. Tries to don't argue, gets tackled. He's going to get it back. Kicks it in the tackle. And it looks like it's going to be claimed there by Sid for Chile. It's sent forward into the 22 and there's a good mark taken. And he looked like he was going to play on. He has played on. He decided too late to go back and he's going to have to play on now. He's taken a couple of ugly bounces in the wind. Good pressure on here.
Look at that.
The captain has been smothered and luckily with the last touch out of bounds rule, he is going to get the ball back. He's kicked in the middle and he's kicked it straight to a South African player. That being Dupree, he's bombed it very long indeed. And has been, unfortunately, for South African fans, marked by a Chilean player. Looks like Rivero's taking it wide. He has passed it back to Soto, who's spread it to the other side of the field. Classic switch, who's passed it inside to Perry Vargas. He's telling his team to go long. They need that safety net. Those two goal buffer isn't enough. And there has been a great mark taken in the forward line. Not sure who that was by. That was a very strong grab, surrounded by multiple men. Yeah, you're welcome. He's done half the job. He's taken a good mark. Now he's just got to finish the job. Restore that 3-goal lead. He steps in. And he has missed. That was Contreras there. He's missed one from straight in front. South Africa now a bit of a let off, chance to go long. It's a big pack of South African players there. It was a 3-on-1. And none of the three managed to take it down. Number one, Lawrence has gone long there. Look like he went to Andrews. Andrews to the captain, Dupree. That wasn't the captain, that was the vice-captain, Taft. St. John Taft has scored another goal for South Africa. That is 4 to South Africa, 5 to Chile, and this game is tightening up once again. So that halftime lead has shrunk all the way to only 1 goal. South Africa, whatever was said at halftime, is clearly working at the moment.
Let's go, Stuart!
It's a good battle in the middle. Comes out favourably for South Africa. Taken by Weiss, he's going to go forward. Pokes it out wide to Andrews, he's going to take it on the wing. Tries to turn his man, gets tackled and is called holding the ball. Vargas takes the mark on halfway as they exit their defensive line. He kicks it long, forward out there to Contreras. Can't reel that one in, unfortunately. It's going to be a kick in for South Africa. It's called play on, even though it looked like the captain, Dupree, might have had it. A good hand in there from Riveros. He's got it back again. Enser in there as well as Weiss. Come away with Vargas though, and he's kicked it long, a long way back. And it's gone through for a goal, but I think it was from his side of halfway. So I think the umpire's going to have a bit of a conference, but I don't think it's going to be called a goal. That's one of the AFI World 9 rules. They're a little bit different. So it's going to be a kick in for South Africa. Oh, and a running straight through with a great take. And it's hit the crossbar. It has hit the crossbar and gone out for a kick in. How unlucky can you get? South Africa going to rebound real quickly as well.
I love this game, BT. What can I say?
It's going out. Butler's running down the line. A big long kick. Good bump. Oh, that's Lawrence there, 1-on-1. He's out-muscled his man. He's trying the stiff arm. He's trying another one. He's got out of two. He's handballed into the captain. He's tried to kick it. Oh, and it's been touched through by a desperate Chilean hand. By the looks of things, and that's going to be, I think, a kick in for Chile. Wow, that was some incredible action right there. Down Chile are open. Lots of South African players looking tired after that little attacking foray. Oh, that's a great mark. One-handed by Contreras for Chile. And he's going to take a look at a harder shot than the one he missed before, but a very important one. Not much time left on the clock now. If he could kick this, it might just be the sealer. Lots of people trying to psych him out, and he has put it straight down the middle. That is the sixth goal for Chile. Scores are 6-4. And that might just about be it. Not much time left on the clock, but there is still time. There is still enough time if South Africa can do something real special here. So the ball's tossed up again. It's come out to a Chilean player who's baited the South African players away to give his other players a bit more space. It's gone forward. South Africa are charging in at this point. They need to get this ball down the other end really quickly. Looks like there's been a high tackle given. It's going to go South Africa's way. They're going to rebound really quickly here. Looks like that was Lombard who got that free kick. Kicked it to Enser on the lead. He's dropped the mark. Snaps it around his body. Got it forward. And it looks like it's going to be a South African ball. South Africa can take it quickly. Taft, the vice-captain there, tries to find Ensor, but a strong mark there from Soto in the back line might just snuff out any chance that they have left. The score is Chile 6, South Africa 4. Not much time left at all. That was Fredericks there trying hard, trying to get in the face of the Chilean players. And a good mark taken by, I think that might be Perry Vargas there. Tries to take on two South African players, gets met and is gone. Fredericks tries to play on quickly, has to take it back to the mark, of course. Anton Wies, number 14, has got it on the halfway line. Is there any time left? That is the final siren. And despite a great comeback in the second half, Chile are your Division 2 World Nines champions. Division 2 champions for 2021. What an amazing game we just saw there. Incredible contest.
Absolutely, it was, BT. We've still got one more to go. Now, there is what looks to be the presentations from that game. As I head down once more with... As I head down...
Two final. And there's still one more to go. Coming up after this presentation is going to be the Division 1 men's final between South Sudan and Samoa. Stay tuned for that. But for now, congratulations to Chile, our Division 2 champions for 2021.
Okay, what a fantastic game of footy. Just witnessed an epic clash between Chile and South Africa. Can I ask both teams to come over to the presentation area, please? Okay, guys, we're about to start. First of all, I think the crowd will agree that was a sensational game of footy. Well, they don't. So well done. I thought it was a great game, guys. And I just want to say to the non-winners, if I can use that term, South Africa, great effort. Your debut at the last World Nines, no wins. This time... Yeah, we'll get to you, Chile, thank you. Going back to South Africa, well done, and you've come a long way. I'd like to get up the captain, stand to say a few words. Thank you.
Mana, baie, geluk. I can't be any more proud of the guys. How this whole thing started a couple of years ago, first World Nines, we didn't win one game, to actually facing off in a grand final versus these great guys. Hats off to you all, guys. That was awesome. And for those that don't know, this is just a group of mates who pitched up one week and thought, yeah, look, we're all from a rugby background. Footy on a rugby field, what could go wrong? Awesome, guys. Well done. You did really, really well.
Well done. Heel lekker, heel goed. Dank je wel, meneer. Okay. Before we do the presentations, we're going to announce as the MVP of the game as adjudged by the umpires. Number 13 from Viva Chile. So well done, mate. Great effort, great game. Now to call up the captain of Chile to say a few words in English, please.
Firstly, I'd like to say thanks to South Africa. You guys played with a lot of heart. I know the first game was a bit of biffo and whatever, but you guys put that aside and it was a fucking good contest. To this group here, mate, it's been a long time. We've put a lot of time and effort. We've got the right group now. And like, honestly, it's one of the best feelings to be a part of this community, but to just give back and just enjoy it as mates, as a country, and let alone as one big community. But thanks to Brian for this, mate.
Muchas gracias, amigo. And we honest, la pelota es muy bueno, no? Lo siento, mi español es muy malo, pero lentamente es mejor. Gracias. Yeah. So we'll just get the captain to come back. And, he's buggered off already. Sorry, mate. Yeah. You know the players better than I do. Just call them up, mate.
Well, we'll start off with Brian. Calm down, mate. Big buzzer. Antonio Watts, bull against Skinny. Jackson Vargas.
He killed it.
Mr. David Carino, TPC, on the decks. Richard Benny Vargas. He killed it. On ya, Richie. He's tall. Our model, Wilbur.
Oh, no, man. That's the reason for it, man.
Are you going to move on?
The fossil of the team, Stephen Soto.
Soto. Oh, man.
All-star midfield, Perry Vargas. It's the Christian Marimiotta.
I got tired of asking questions.
I don't know. Our woman will be soon.
People have met me back in the kitchen.
Mr. Kemba!
That's good. We'll say bye to these guys.
Thanks, mate. Kicking all the snags, Morris. Big Noz.
Morris.
That's what I'm talking about! Yeah!
Sit down, big nose.
Is that it? I think that's it. All right. Yeah, myself. Oh, yeah, you can have it, mate. Thanks, mate. Appreciate it.
All right, we have one more thing left to do. I'd like to call up the captain of Chile. Come back, mate. And the coach, and the coach. Get the coach in as well. Ron, come over here, please, mate. So I'd like to call upon Ron to present the cup to the coach and captain of Team Chile. Well done, guys. Congratulations, our Division 2 champions. Team Chile, well done, guys.